Hi everyone, welcome to Python learning series for network engineers. In this video we'll see how to use Napalm Python library for configuring or getting information from networking devices. Napalm library can interact with multiple vendors, networking devices or operating system using unified API. Unified API means using same code we'll be able to configure multiple vendors devices. Only the loading drivers will vary. You can see the list of supported devices here. It's the EOS, Cisco IOS, Cisco XR, NX OS, etc. And here you can see one of the sample code for loading the driver. So first we need to import the get network driver from Napalm. Then you can import get the network driver of respective vendor. Napalm will be using individual vendors library for configuring the devices in the backend. To see the supported devices and its backend libraries, we can go to supported devices here, and here you can see the supported images and backend library Napalm uses. For Arista EOS, it uses PI EAPI, and NXOS, it is using PI NXOS, and for iOS, it uses Netmiko. Netmiko we have seen in our previous videos. And there is, for managing the configuration, there is certain methods: configure, replace, configure, merge, config, compare, rollback. We'll be seeing all these in detail. Then for getting the outputs, it supports list of the commands. Irrespective of vendors, when you execute these commands from Napalm, you will be getting the output in a structured way. Now we will see how to install Napalm in our Python environment. For that we'll go to tutorial, then installation. Here you can see the command to install Napalm, pip install Napalm. There is some dependency libraries, but once you execute this command, you'll be installing all the dependency library, all the backend libraries for individual vendors. We'll see that in detail. So before we install, we'll see current list of libraries in Python. We'll note it down and we'll see the difference after installing Napalm. I'll put it in Notepad. We'll do a comparison. Now the command to install Napalm is pip install Napalm. You can see all the vendor library it is installing. Now we'll do a comparison of our library list. Yeah, you can see the libraries which it installed. This has installed Certify. For Nexus, it has installed NX API. Then for Juniper, it installed a Juniper library. In addition to that, here you can see iOS XR, then PI EAPI for Cisco, then URL lib3 request. These are some of the major libraries it installed. You can see here, Netmiko I already have. And here you can see Napalm 2.4.0. Now we'll see one of the sample code from Napalm official site. For that we need to go to programming samples. I'll give the summary of this code here. First we need to import the library Napalm, then loading the library using loading the driver using this command here, driver equal to Napalm dot get underscore network driver EOS. Here particularly they are loading EOS driver, they're using Arista device. Then we need to define the device using the driver, host name. Here we need to give IP, username and password. then using device.open, it is connecting to the device. Then using the load replace candidate method, they are sending the configuration from the file config underscore file, and you can see here the message, the description here. Note that changes have not been applied yet. Before applying the configuration, you can check the changes. That means it just loads the configuration to the device, but it will not apply. And after that, using the method device.compare config, it compares the configuration, and using the print statement, it will print the complete configuration difference from the current device configuration. Then it will ask whether to commit the changes or not. If you give yes, it will, using the method device.commit config, it will save the configuration. Otherwise, it will discard the config. Then we need to close the connection. We will see this in detail in this video. So first, we will see the steps to manipulate the configuration. Here we can see, first we need to load the driver, then we need to define the device using the driver, then using device.open we need to connect to the device. After that, we can see here multiple methods to manipulate the configuration. One is replacing the configuration, so the command is load underscore replace candidate. If you use this method, it will replace complete configuration of the device with another file. So we can use this when we need to replace the configuration with the backup config file. Another method you can see here, it is for saving the configuration. Then if you want to discard the changes, you can use discard config. Another method is merging configuration. If you want to add certain lines to existing configuration, you can use this method. And either you can directly give command here using config equals, or you can fetch it from a file using this method, file equal to. And before committing the configuration, we can do a comparison using this method. Then if user want to commit the config, once the user give yes, we can commit the config, or we can discard the config. Another method is rollback. After committing, if you want to roll back to the previous state, we can use rollback method. In this video, we'll be covering the method load merge candidate. For that, I have a configuration here, 29 underscore Cisco route. Here I have 5 route lines I added. I'll be adding this to one of the device using load merge candidate method. Then we will do a comparison with the current device configuration. We will display the difference. If user gives yes, it will commit, or it will discard the config. In the next video, we will see how to do a replace configuration with the backup file and how to do a rollback changes. Now we'll copy this script, and I have created a file here, 29 napalm Cisco config file compare. Here the driver is going to be iOS. In the upcoming videos, I'll be covering the same methods using Arista EOS, Cisco Nexus, etc. My device IP is 6743. Username is admin. Password always admin. And once I do this, it will get connected to the device. Now we need to get the load merge candidate. We'll copy these two scripts. Here, instead of config, we need to give file name. So you can do it in two ways. Either you can give the commands directly here, or you can use this method. We use this method, file name. So file name equal to 29 underscore Cisco underscore route. That is a file name. Since we use Python 3 here, we need to add additional parentheses here. Now we'll try to execute the script. So what it does, it loads the configuration file and prints the difference. Python 29. Yeah, now this has printed the difference. At this point, if you get a IP SCP service not enabled error from the device, you can just configure that in the Cisco device using this command IP SCP server enable. Once you do that, it'll work. In this device, by default, it accepted, so you don't have to do that. Now, instead of config merge, if I do a load replace here, it will replace the complete configuration with this 5 lines of configuration. We'll try that. Yeah, you can see here. So what it says, it will remove all the other configuration from the device and it will add only these 5 lines. So when you do the config replace, you need to give the complete working configuration. Otherwise, it will replace complete configuration with whatever file or whatever the line of commands which you are giving. So we need to change this to config merge itself. In the next video, we will see how config replace works. And I will add one of the line into device configuration. And now if you try to execute it, it will show only the 4 lines because my configuration file is having 5 lines and this line already exists in device. Yeah, now you can see this shows only 4 lines. Now we'll provide a prompt to the user asking, would you like to commit the configuration? We'll copy that from here, from the sample script. We'll take this and it'll ask, would you like to commit these changes? If user gives yes, it'll commit, otherwise it'll discard the config. We'll copy this and paste it here. So here first it will prompt for the message, then if we give yes, it will commit, else it will discard the config. So we need to put it under choice. We'll try to execute it now. Yeah, now it is asking the message, I'll give no. So it is discarding the configuration. Okay, now we will add another case here. Like if there is no difference, we don't need to ask, would you like to commit these changes? Directly it should close and it should print a message saying that there is no difference. And if there is any message, then it should ask, Would you like to commit these changes? So for that, we'll create a statement here. If length of device.compare is greater than 0, then ask for this. Else print no difference. And now we will remove all the configuration except first line, because this line is already there in the device. So we'll try to execute the script again. Yeah, now this has printed no difference. Now we'll add these additional lines. And we'll execute again. Now this asks, would you like to commit these changes? I'll give yes. So before that, we will verify our configuration. Show running. I have only one line, one route line, and show startup. There also I have only one line. Now after giving yes, we will see. Check our startup config. Yeah, you can see additional line has been added here, even in running as well. So if you want to revert, you can revert it using the revert method. We'll see replace and revert method in the next video. I hope this video was helpful for you to understand how to do config compare, config merge, config commit and discard using Napalm. In the next video, we'll see replace and revert. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.